That will change the machine. revolutionary. My inconsolable superpower, cloaked to consciousness in a dream, tries to redirect an agreement upon waking, gets trapped in form, squirming way back into the upright position. I'm learning hand-to-hand combat so I can go toe-to-toe with you, and it will be no contest and it will be no fun. Meanwhile, I learn to garden. The worker be on my own terms. Blushing as my fingers sink into the dirt. Forced but dressed in fluorescence. Echoing from the trees' childish music. Prune and draw. I don't need to be young again. But it's a sign of what we all can push back against. A slow while recovering the earth to solidify things in their place. Youth is movement and wisdom is stillness. But old age will drag you into professional deafening. Beware of the bloating. A daze to swim through in someone else's body.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
I'm exhausted. I ever were robust. I'm not, after all that build-up. Is it very hot in here or only for lecturers? I'm very warm. I have been seized with all kinds of tremors today. I then asked myself, of course, by what right on God's earth do I deign to speak on these subjects? After all, therefore, I'm not properly qualified to discuss this. Then I thought, well, golly, maybe I'm better qualified to discuss it just because of that, because since half the time I cease to be and switch off that magic little off and on switch, perhaps thereby I earn a certain kind of objectivity which I otherwise might not have. It's very hard to describe it. People have tried to describe it for centuries. The identity, the sameness of the shooter of the arrow and the target, the identification of the hitter and the hit. This is kind of a loss of ego. And the only way you can really digest this formulation is to experience it. I have never yet found a formulation of words that really adequately describes this state. As you lie on a bed or on the floor or wherever, and the conscious mind becomes hazier and hazier. Watch yourself fantasizing. Is that too clumsily stated? If, in other words, you can allow yourself the freedom of the fantasy, if same time, the control of watching yourself, then I think you've hit it. That's kind of the moment you want. Enough to remember it. And to appreciate it. And to know how to go about making it permanent. That is, when you arrive back at consciousness, formulate the vision into something communicable to other people, then I suppose you've hit the ideal state. Now this all sounds terribly mystic and magical and mysterious. And I don't mean to be any of these things, because I think it's kind of pompous to talk this way. On the other hand, there is a reality to it, and it's awfully hard to think without thinking of this almost mystic procedure. So one is forced to talk this way, even though it may be a little pretentious. What is conceived in this trance? Well, at the best, the optimum is a totality, a whole form, a work. One is very lucky if this happens.